Hi!
Hello, and welcome to the Daily Almanac for May 5th. So, let's get started.
First day in history!
On this day in history, May 5th, 1945, Charles A. Gonzalez was born. He's an Hispanic-American member of Congress from Texas. Before becoming a congressman, he was a teacher, a lawyer, and a judge. Also, on this day in 1961, a group of Freedom Riders left Washington, D.C. for New Orleans. The Freedom Riders were a group of men and women, black and white, young and old, from across the country who boarded buses, trains, and planes bound for the South. Their goal was to challenge the region's laws about race. They also wanted to point out where states were not obeying a U.S. Supreme Court ruling prohibiting segregation in all public transportation between states. Also on this day in 1961, America's first astronaut in space, Alan Shepard Jr., made a 15-minute flight that reached an altitude of 115 miles, or 173 kilometers. Shepard was the first American in space. However, the world's first human in space was Yuri Gagarin, a Russian cosmonaut who was launched into orbit less than 1 month earlier on April 12, 1961.
Word power!
Today on Word Power, we're going to talk about the phrase, knocking on wood. Now, some people believe that if you say something like, I haven't had a cold all year, or we won every game this season, you're inviting bad luck. In order to protect yourself from the bad luck, they believe that you have to knock on a piece of wood. Now, there are many theories about where this superstition began. Some people believe that knocking on wood was a way to make sure that evil spirits or the devil couldn't hear them when they made such claims. People who study the history of stories say that the phrase knocking on wood was introduced into our daily language by a children's game called Tiggy Touch Wood. In Tiggy Touch Wood, you were safe from being tagged if you were touching wood.
Oh, extremes.
Today on Extremes, we ask, where was the greatest snowfall over a year-long period ever recorded? The answer is at Mount Rainier in Washington State. Between 1971 and 1972, 102 feet, or 31 meters, of snow fell. Mount Rainier is close to the Pacific Ocean. At the ocean, water evaporates from clouds and the clouds move east to Mount Rainier. Mount Rainier catches the clouds and forces them upwards into cooler air, which makes the snow fall. That's why this mountain gets so much snow every winter.
Health tips.
Poisons are things that can make you sick. Things such as household cleaners, other people's prescription drugs, paints, and oil products. Stay away from poisons. Do not touch them. Do not eat them. Do not sniff or inhale them. And do not get them in your eyes. The bald eagle was made the national bird of the United States in 1782. The image of the bald eagle can be found in many places in the U.S., such as on the Great Seal, federal agency seals, the president's flag, and the $1 bill. The founders wanted to choose an animal that was unique to the United States. For 6 years, the members of Congress engaged in a debate over what the national emblem should be. The bald eagle was chosen because it stands for strength, courage, freedom, and immortality. Well, that's all the time we have left today for Daily Almanac. Thanks for stopping by, and I hope to see you tomorrow.